think that the real problem for Harry is that it demonstrates just such appalling judgment. I mean, you know, to play a game of strip poker, strip billiards, hey, so what? But to do so with a number of girls you've just met on, you know, in the casino at Las Vegas over the past 18 months, really since the royal wedding, you know, he hasn't really put a foot wrong. He's been building, you know, very carefully and very slowly, really being rehabilitated from being this kind of youthful,
exactly. That's why I opened this segment, Tom. It's why I opened it with those Olympic images. He seemed to be, we almost all forgot about all of the silliness early and thought that he'd grown out of it. And now I gosh, this might show how old I am, but the first thing I thought was, oh, it's just like his Uncle Andy, Randy Andy. Remember the whole Coup Stark thing? And now I feel like he's going to be branded once again as Dirty Harry. But gosh, if this was a princess, there'd be no way anybody would give him a pass.
Well, now that is a really interesting point, is that Harry gets away with a lot still because, you know, we're such an inherently sexist society that it's okay for a guy to do this. Yeah, I mean, if this was Beatrice or Eugenie, forget about it. I think that the thing that's sort of really going to be interesting over the next couple of weeks is what role is Harry going to have now in the Paralympics? Now, because the Paralympics ceremony event obviously are opening in London next week. Wow. Now, Harry wasn't supposed to be opening that, but he was expected to attend a number of events there. Now, I spoke to Buckingham Palace this morning, and they are suggesting that he may still attend some events at the Paralympics. So I think that'll be very interesting to see, really. But I think it's very, very bad, not so much just for Harry, but for the whole royal family. And I think it's particularly embarrassing for Prince Charles. And I'll tell you why. There's been a bit of a power struggle in the British royal family over the past year. And Charles has really sidelined Prince Andrew and Beatrice and Eugenie, his daughters, the princesses. And you may remember after the Jubilee, the balcony appearance was restricted to just Charles, William, and Harry. So that was Charles saying, this is the future, this is the royal family of the future. Obviously, yeah, it was Charles who lobbied for him to be given that tremendous honor of representing the Queen at the closing of the Olympics.
Well,
and I think there's a lot of egg on Charles's face over this. I say, yeah, for Harry, he'll laugh it off.